Okay, so we are here at the Düsseldorf Boat Show and we're on the Love Your Ocean stand and we have the pleasure of being joined by Frank Schreckert, who is the founder of the German Ocean Foundation. So do you want to tell us a little bit about the foundation?
Yeah, the foundation is kind of umbrella because we need to gain all the forces for our oceans. So the forces from industry, from society and from science to get more sustainability and get more pleasure also from the ocean and with the ocean.
Fantastic. And I know there's quite a few initiatives that you do. You've got your expedition and research vessel. You hold educational platforms. Do you want to just give us the highlights of, I guess, maybe your favorite?
I think the highlight is this Love Your Ocean initiative, yeah. Because we provide a stage for more than 100 partners from industry, from science, from society, and we make workshops, we have a stage, we have a scientific area where we can look to plankton and plastic, for example. A large theme is sound in the ocean, so we have some experiments how probably fishes will listen to what happened in the water, on the water surface, and the problem of noise pollution in the oceans. And all these things are addressed here.
Fantastic. There's so much to learn in this stand. And Frank's going to introduce us to one of the scientists, I believe, who we're going to ask some really sailing-specific questions to give you guys an idea of how to look after our ocean. Thank you very much, Frank.
You're welcome.
So we are here with Frida, who is a marine biologist on the Love Your Ocean stand. And basically we're going to ask you a little bit about what you do and a few questions to really help sailors understand, you know, how they can affect the ocean, etc. So, I mean, the first thing to ask you about is this microscope and this screen here. What is it we're looking at here?
Well, today we bring to the this exposition, like some microscopes and some water samples from the river close to here. And what we want to bring to everybody and all the people is about what is living in a just tiny, tiny drop of water, which is plankton. And this is plankton that we can also find in the oceans. This one is can be active swimming around, but it also has like a feet where he can attach to a substrate. And something else that we can see here is they're called ciliates and they're in the mouth. So it can filter the water and then eat what he wants.
Which is important to think about. So if we're on the boat and we can't see fish or anything, it doesn't mean there's nothing in there. It's just so important to understand. So for example, first question is, the products that we're using every day, like shampoo, fairy liquid, how are they affecting life under the ocean?
We are sailing and we, of course, use some products when we want to take a shower or when we eat some food aboard. So where does the waste go? So this goes to the ocean. So how this pollution and waste damage them is they create an excess of nutrients, and this affects other stages of on the food webs.
I see. So the way that the products or chemicals within the products break down is affecting how the plankton, etc., are living and reproducing and. Okay, yeah. Interesting. So all the little things that you forget about. And so another thing that sailors do all the time is obviously anchor. So we're dropping the anchor in a bay, which obviously is affecting whatever is on the seabed. How does that disrupt the seabed, things we don't see?
Yeah. Well, it depends where you are anchoring, but we have so many habitats under the sea. Like we have seagrass, we have corals, and even for example in the sand, we don't see, but inside the sands, there's so much life living too, worms and polychaetes and so much bivalves. And when we think about what do we eat? For example, I don't know if you eat fish or other organisms. Like, the food comes from the ocean. Ensuring like that can affect all these ecosystems that are home from these species. So,
It's really worthwhile bearing that in mind. And one key tip off the top of my head is making sure you get the right amount of anchor chain out in the first place so you don't end up dragging, because there's one thing dropping your anchor on top of one patch. If you then end up dragging over the bay, you're then disrupting so much more of it. So I guess that's an easy thing to do to avoid that. And the other big topic in the industry is obviously electric motors taking over diesel engines. So from our perspective, diesel, as sailors, you know, you see sort of diesel scum over the top of the water, and you think, oh, that's not great. Can you help explain more scientifically what that diesel is doing to things in the water?
Yes, well, I think diesel is one of the most substance that can damage an ecosystem. Like that, the diesel in the water means like completely bad conditions for all organisms that live there. So like oil and all these substances, like as soon as they start to accumulate in the water, they create anoxic conditions for the organisms. That means like no oxygen disponible in the water. So that over the time, when there is like too much of these contaminants, that means that these organisms cannot live anymore. So that means like the conditions in the ecosystem will be get really bad, and the ecosystems will die eventually. So it's one of the most important like contaminants in our waters.
And one last thing, which I know sailors can heavily affect the ocean by, is so something that we call antifoul on the bottom of the boat. It's basically a paint that prevents sea life clinging on to the bottom of the boat. Basically, it's chemicals and biocides on the boat that will be essentially leaking into the ocean. Is that a similar effect with diesel?
It's a similar effect, but something, for example, that happened with these friends with the plankton is that sometimes these chemicals are very, very strong. That means their composition, it's very dangerous even for contact human.
Well, this is the thing,
So imagine like these organisms are made from like cells. Like they're like their bodies are very sensible for them. So that means that as well, like if they avoid to the grow in the boats, that means as well that it's not healthy for them either. So the organisms cannot live there in that area. Like imagine that where the like a port or it is like the organism, this life there will start to die because these conditions are not proper for them anymore. So the fact is kind of the same one.
Okay, so I mean the plankton is unreal. It's so small, but obviously it's got a quite big effect on the rest of the ecosystem. Can you explain that a little bit more for us?
Yes, of course. Well, plankton, first of all, we found it in all water bodies in the planet, and when we chew all this pollution in the water from the boats, what we do to these organisms is that they eventually die because they don't have the conditions to grow and eat and develop it normally. So what happened is that these organisms are the base of the food web. That means that other organisms feed on them, like fish, like whales, like all the animals in the oceans feed on them. And when they disappear, then the other animals cannot exist anymore.
So they are the center of the food chain. Like without them, nothing exists. So it's really important here as sailors, even if there's no fish down there, there's really important things living in the water and living in the sand that we've got to protect.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, huge effect. It's scary how we're affecting our ocean. And yeah, we need a huge push to be looking for eco-friendly products. I'm sure we could ask Frida so many more questions from a sailor's perspective, but thank you so much for your time.
No, thank you.
And maybe we'll see you in the water one day.
Yeah, we'd love to.
Thank you.
So clearly sustainability is taking off. So if you want to find out more about sustainability and also more about just general industry and how it's happening and how it's progressing in technology, stick with us at Sail Hub, because that's what we're all about. We'll see you next time.